Good morning, my dear students. Now we will discuss today class 10 physics. That continue to discuss that is already we learned about which one? Convex lens. Now we will discuss concave lens. So see here, concave lens. Concave lens is like this. That means this curved surface is inverse. This is curved towards inverse is curved. This is known as concave lens. So in this case, this is the center of the optical center. This is optical center, and this optical center is always denoted by O. This is optical, optical center, and this optical center is denoted by O. Clear this one? So this concave lens is known as also diverging lens. Diverging lens. But because one ray of light passes through this concave lens. See here, this is air medium, this is glass medium, and this is again air medium. That means air medium is rarer medium and glass medium is denser medium, and again air medium is also rarer medium. So in this lens, in this when the ray of light enters through this lens, its speed will be changed. That means rare to denser. Suppose this is the which one normal, then it will go like this towards the normal, then again away from the normal. See here, this is the normal, then it is away from the normal. That means in this case, this ray of light getting diverged. Therefore, this lens is known as diverging lens. So it has two important rules. What is that one? See here. First one is case one. Case one is what is when the ray of light or the incident ray of light when passes through, this is known as which one? Already you know this one is which one? This is known as principal axis. This is known as principal axis. And this is known as optical center O. And when the ray of light which is parallel to the principal axis, which is parallel to the principal axis, after striking this lens, it gets like this. It gets diverged. It gets diverged. But when we float this ray of light backward, then it looks like this light is coming from this point. That means in this case, the incident ray of light, which is parallel to the principal axis, after striking the lens, it gets diverged. Similarly, another case is there. That case is what is this case is when the ray of light, see here, this is the concave lens. So this is known as principal axis. Then when the ray of light passes through optical center, see here, this is optical center. So when ray of light, incident ray of light passes through this optical center, it is undeviated. It is undeviated. That means the ray of light never gets bent. So you have to remember these two cases. Then we will start image formation by concave lens. Image formation. Formation by concave lens. So there are two cases here. First case, case one is what is suppose this is the which one? This is concave lens and this is optical center and this is suppose which one? Principal axis. So this is focus F1, this is focus 2F1, this is focus the the distance is there. This is optical sensor O. This is focus F2, and this is shell distance. This is the focus 2 and F2. Clear this one? So, when the array of when the object is at any point, beyond the center, otherwise object is between F2 and 2F2. Suppose this is the object here. Suppose this is A and this is B. So always for image formation we need minimum two rays for image formation. So first ray which is parallel to the principal axis, after striking the lens get diverse. Yes or no? Then when we plot backwardly, it looks like it coming from this focus. And second ray, which is passes through this optical center, it is never deviated. That means this is undeviated. So in this case, these two rays are intersecting at point this point. So this is known as which one? A dash and B dash. So here image is A. So what is image? First point is between. Image is created between where? Between F2 and optical center O. And second one is because these two rays are not intersecting actually, they appear to meet to each other. Therefore, the image is virtual image. If it is virtual, then it is erect image or upright image. It is erect or upright image. And see size of object and size of image. Size of image is diminis. So next case we will discuss. Next.